to raise from the dead, so that we can be assured that we can be forgiven, that we can be assured that the words that came out of his mouth were from you, Lord, that we have the truth. And Lord, I just ask that you would move in the service, that we would be encouraged, that we would sing your praises, that we would obey your word. And Lord, that those who look on, those who may not know about this, that they may hear and respond.
It says, now Thomas, called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. And that's why he was the one who had the question. He hadn't seen. The other disciples therefore said to him, we have seen the Lord. So he said, interesting. All this was written in the Old Testament scriptures. Everything they're doing was prophesied many, many years before these events are happening, and they happened exactly the way it was prophesied. And for us is, God created you and me to have a relationship with him. He wants you and me to know him and to have a relationship with him. He actually wants you to have a relationship with him, not just on Easter, or not just on Christmas. 365, sometimes 366 days a year, he wants every day, he wants to have a relationship with you because he loves you. Romans 5 verse 10, it says, for if when we were sinners, enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his son, much more having been reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. We serve a risen Savior. He died for us, yes. He was buried, yes. But he rose again. And so the one we talk about, Jesus, is alive today. He's not still nailed to a cross. He's not still in a tomb. The tomb's empty. The cross is empty. Jesus Christ took up his life and walked out of that cross. And so the good gospel, which means good news, is Jesus is alive. He really is. And Romans chapter 8, verse 32 tells us something. It says, he who did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Peace with God and eternal life are ours through the sacrifice of the Son of God. That's what you inherit when you believe on Jesus and you ask him to be your Savior. So to me, Jesus demonstrated that God is absolutely unselfish. He didn't hold anything back. He gave the best. He gave his son for you and for me. He didn't save you and me for some selfish reason. He gave his son's life because he loves you and because we were due the consequence of our sin, which would be death. And God said they can't pay this. There's none righteous, no, not one. And so God sent his son to take your sin on himself and to die in your place. That's what Jesus did for you and for me. Galatians 3:13 says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having become a curse for us, for it's written, cursed is everyone who hangs on a tree. I've been praying and thinking about this week, that. And I was thinking, it's good for me to set an example to you, for you, and for me to make sure that I'm right with God, or I have no business to stand here. I really don't. So I'm going to do something I've been praying about this week. It's just between me and my Savior. I want to rededicate my life to Christ. When Jesus Christ was nailed to a cross, he took my sin. He died for me. He suffered for me. And I want to just demonstrate that to you, that I recognize that I'm the one who nailed him to the cross. And I want to take this card with my recommitment on it. Nailing myself, my sin, to the cross. I'm going to give you an opportunity to do that in the future. Next week. I just want you to pray about it. You're going to have an opportunity for anyone who is willing to rededicate yourself to Jesus Christ to come. And so next week we'll give you a card. During the service, we're going to have a quiet time. We're going to do a little bit different next week. And we'll give you time to respond if God has lead you that way. To just nail your sins to the cross again. Rededicate yourself to Jesus again. And today I'm asking, there may be someone here who's never done that. Maybe you've never asked Jesus Christ to be your Savior, the Lord of your life. Today could be the day when you fulfill what Jesus came for you to do. Jesus is the only one who could actually die for you and me, because he has no sin. He made a way, and he is the way. There's only one way. It's Jesus, to be saved from our sin. And he's calling you and me to make a decision. And the decision he's calling you and me to make is today, is to choose Jesus or not. That's it. There's only two choices. Jesus came to save you and me when you and I could not ever have saved ourselves. Never. Don't ever look at me and say that I'm any better than the worst sinner. I'm not. I'm only saved by grace through faith. Period. He came to set me free and to set you free if you believe on him. That's what he did. Look at Mark.